Hello, my name is Malik Mnela, and I'm the founder and managing editor for iHub Online. This is a digital media startup based in Malawi, Lilongwe to be specific. And in this presentation, I'm going to tell you what iHub is all about and what we have been doing over the past year since our establishment. And this presentation will highlight what we have this far achieved, the challenges that we are facing, and the ambitious plans that we have going into the future. So iHub Online is a digital media company that is based in Lilongwe, the capital of Malawi. And we are ambitious in the sense that we are trying to democratize information amongst a population segment that is not regarded as viable by the mainstream media due to several factors. So this is a segment for the underprivileged, but we also work with stakeholders that will also work to target these. And these include the government, the NGO sector, as well as the not-for-profit institutions. Our mission really is to offer low-cost, professionally moderated media services on the internet. So we are trying to leverage on the opportunities that are presented by the internet. We all understand that the internet may be perceived as expensive, especially in Malawi, which is documented as one of the most expensive countries to be online. Nonetheless, we realize that the internet still provides an opportunity to democratize information in the sense that it collapses all barriers to entry in the media industry, especially for those of us who would like to operate in the media space. So in along the same lines, our vision is to democratize information through innovative methods in the digital space. Like I just said, internet enables us to cheaply venture into the media space without really looking at the cost structure that was hitherto a barrier for those that wanted to venture into the media space. So our business model is hybrid in the sense that we offer freemium news content. We offer content absolutely free, but on the other arm of our business, we have a segment that deals with digital media services, and we offer premium services. And these premium services attract a fee, and this fee enables us to invest in the freemium business model. So the freemium model, as well as the premium model, they work in a hybrid way, and they are complementary to each other. What are our unique attributes? We are small. This enables us to have a niche media focus. We only focus on the digital media space. In the news segment, we offer general news, but in a different way from the way other news outlets do deliver. So in our case, we really target information that has a huge implication on the general population. So that's the news that we'll focus on most. Our operations are mostly virtual. We are operating out of the internet, and that enables us to operate effectively. Only 20% of our operations are conducted in brick and mortar facilities. We thrive on the presence of a tech-savvy crop of journalists that are really reputable. Either these are award-winning, or they are journalists that are known to be reputable in terms of their professional conduct. Now, looking at the achievements that we have made so far, first and foremost, I must mention that these achievements, and most of these achievements, wouldn't have been possible without iHub Online being admitted into the JAMLab. Having been admitted into the JAMLab enable us to assess who we are, where we are coming from, and have an idea of where we want to go. Now, because of this idea, we have managed to secure business, even at a nascent stage. We have managed to secure business from the government of Malawi. And one of the top businesses that we have had is that we have been contracted at some point to manage the virtual meetings of the country's vice president, Dr. Salos Chilima. That is one of our major assignments. We have also been assigned by the United Nations Development Program to manage their webinar, especially the launch of the Human Development Report of 2020, which launches in Malawi locally today. And my company is managing the webinar and the official launch that is taking place online due to COVID-19. We have also managed to handle officially the graduation ceremony of several universities, and we're in the process of handling another graduation ceremony for one of the country's prominent universities. And we are also a recipient of a COVID-19 grant from the European Union through the international media support. And this has helped us build resilience in terms of our news platform online and offering live streams that are public interest journalism in nature. So in a way, you can see that the JAMLAB has positioned us very well to be a niche leader in the digital space in Malawi, not only in providing live streams for public service journalism, but also build resilience in terms of our liquidity and our financial muscle. So our ambition in the long term is to be the niche leader in the digital space, but also in the digital news space. We have had challenges, so our cost structure remains large. Considering our background, we need a lot of resources to acquire state-of-the-art equipment for live streaming. We also operate in a country that is known to be very expensive in terms of internet access. This has two effects. The first effect is that we are not able to have the crowd that we want to have because they are limited and barred by the cost of internet bundles. But on the other hand, we also operate on a tight budget in terms of us acquiring those bundles. But it's something that we are proud of to have received the grant from the EU, because it has enabled us to procure better internet, which is relatively expensive, and it has enabled us to provide our services in a much better way. Now, our ask is that if we were asked to name a figure that would enable us operate effectively and avoid the bottlenecks that we are facing, possibly something within the $25,000 budget for the next 1 year and a half should enable us to acquire the assets that we require and also take care of the most prominent costs, especially the internet would be taken care of on that budget. So way forward, we believe that a sustainable capacity building effort is something that we have in mind, because we noted that the capacity that we built through the JAMLAB has enabled us to get a 60% jump in our revenue. But also we would want to look at the options for diversified revenue. We would also want to leverage on partnerships. We would also want to get into as many fellowships as possible so that we equip our human resource. We would also want to see a lot more business coming our way and taking advantage of our digital preparedness, but also would want to leverage on low-cost innovations that will encourage people to go online. Now, the journey continues. We are certainly at a stage where we cannot say that our business model is refined. We are open to suggestions. We are open to ideas. We are open to insights, such that those of you who believe have ideas that can help us become better at what we do, that's indeed most welcome. Thank you very much for your attention.